All right, we're gonna hit the payroll van. It leaves the edge of Chinatown every day. Bullets won't even dent the van's armor, so get a car and ram it off the road. Now hit it hard, and the punk-ass security guard should bail. And take it to the warehouse at the docks, and my guys are gonna take over from there. Now it won't be doing its rounds all day, so don't hang around.
Things used to be better. Always trouble. Things used to be better.
Yeah, no, Tony, I've tuned her real sweet. She purrs, you know what I mean? Oh, here's the guy I was telling you about. All right, listen, this guy, he ain't Italian, and he's no mechanic, but he could get things fixed. This is Pop's capo, Tony Cipriani.
Yeah, I'm Tony Cipriani.
Take him to Mama's restaurant in St. Mark's, all right? Now listen to me. I'm planning a job that needs a good driver, so drop by sometime later, okay?
Okay, kid, drive me to the laundry in Chinatown first. I got a bit of business to take care of. Those washerwomen ain't been paying their protection money. And watch the car. Joey just fixed this junk heap. So no fancy crap, okay? right here. Keep the engine running. This ain't a social call. Kid! Triads think they can mess with me. The Triads. With me. Drop by later and we'll give them something to launder. Their own blood-stained clothes. Seat, kid. Take a goddamn seat. So the laundry won't pay any protection, huh? The Triads think they can mess with me? Let's teach these would-be tough guys what it means to be a tough guy.
Teach them some respect. No son of mine gets up by some Triads. Your father,
sorry,
Ma.
Yes, Ma. I want you to destroy their laundry vans and mangle any Triad gimp that gets in your way. 8-Ball can supply you with what you're gonna need.
sorry, Fernando. But here's someone who has, and they paid us in stacks of old groats and gold guineas. We'll be back after this.
Do you live in the boring suburbs but dream of living in a lonely castle on a windswept moor? Do you long to trade in your sweatsuit for a 100-pound suit of armor and swap your SUV for a noble stallion? Do you eat microwave dinners, all the while wishing you were roasting a suckling pig at a pagan banquet? Is your next ideal home improvement a moat? Well, get ready, Liberty City!
This weekend and every weekend at Liberty City Park, it's the Medieval Millennium Fair. Our band of traveling minstrels, knights, and maidens oh so fair are ready to delight you with tales of the Black Death, witch burnings, and the joys of being a feudal serf. Forget about air conditioning and modern medicine. We've got all the leeches, spells, and potions you need at the Medieval Millennium Fair. Learn the art of cooking with turnips. Yum, yum. Buy genuine reproduction medieval artifacts, including maces, double-handed battle swords, and one-size-fits-all chainmail. Rid your condo of vermin using a penny whistle and a mysterious prancing German named Hans. The Medieval Millennium Fair, every weekend at Liberty City Park.
All right, Liberty City, you are listening to Chatterbox, the show that is the number one reason for the success of the internet. All right, let's take a call. Who's on the line?
Clothes.
What about them?
Clothes.
What are you talking about?
Laszlo, clothes, Laszlo. I hate them. I just hate them.
Wait, we're all about opinions on Chatterbox, which is Liberty City's premier phone-in station. But why don't you like clothes?
I just hate them. They're so constricting. I mean, there's a lion wear clothes, and the lion is the king of the jungle. So why can't I, a humble citizen, go naked?
Well, I mean, I guess a lion has two distinct advantages over you. One, I mean, it's, as you say, a king, and therefore it can exercise its royal prerogative to not wear clothes. And two, it's a cat, and therefore it doesn't have to. And three, I mean, now that I think about it, if you want to try to dress a lion, you can, but I guess what we're learning is that life can be a little unfair at times.
I'm naked, Laszlo. I'm naked.
I really didn't need to know that.
Why, Laszlo? Why? Because you? I was born naked, I'm going to die naked. I'm going to live naked. So there's nothing wrong with being naked. It's so invigorating feeling the hot leather of a chair or the cool wind from the north on your naked body.
I'm going to have to cut you off.
Don't you believe in free speech? Free expression? No, of course you don't. All you believe in is free drinks. I'm naked and there's not a damn thing you can...
up by the sound of things.
Winter was invented by clothing companies. Clothes are unnecessary. They're ugly. Have you ever cooked in the nude?
No. Look, is this leading anywhere? Because, I mean, we've got a lot of other people waiting to talk about real things here.
Nudity is real. Open your eyes. Take off your pants. Come on. Come on, Laszlo. You can be a figurehead for Liberty City Naturist. We have more members now for the first time since 1977. Nudity is back. A lot of people are into nudity and really understand the spiritual side.
What? Of hanging out with loads of naked chicks. I mean, I see the fun in it, but I just think clothes have distinct advantages, like not accidentally cooking yourself, or when you're working on a building.
We're not swingers. It's not about sex. It's about being one with the world.
All right, dude. Groovy. Hug a rainbow. It's time for a public service announcement from Donald Love.
Hello, I'm Donald Love. Under my guidance, Love Media has emerged as the fastest-growing U.S.-run media conglomerate of the past 5 years, with...
Your head needs it. affecting your health? Do you become fatigued? Does working take time away from family and social events like watching wrestling? There's an easy solution. Sue your boss. See, the great thing about this country is you can sue anyone for pretty much anything, and you'll probably win, or at least get a settlement. At the firm of Rickett and Ponser personal injury attorneys, we can show you how falling down and howling like a sissy can result in a large damage award from your employer. We also specialize in awards for injuries suffered in auto, bus, and train accidents, and can even train you to throw yourself in front of a bus and pretend to be injured.
I'm learning him the value of good, hard work. Learning him good. And three, we taught him how to clean bathrooms. He left so much one hair on the soap, it was off the bed with no dinner. You know what? He went to bed hungry only 20, maybe 30 times. He learned. Now he brings his mother lunch in bed every day so she can sleep in. Let me tell you, everyone should have their kids serving up food. He even cooks for the whole family. These days he's getting too big to be tempted, so now he's a paralegal raking him home. Seven and he's making magic for 23,000 a year. No weekend, he doesn't go to the mall, play soccer, feed, or any of that kind of stuff. No, no, he works the base for the McCarthy company making photocopies all night. Now, he goes to sleep during the day, that's another $8,000 right there. Now, I'm buying me a fastball script. What do you say to that?
Well, it sounds kind of like exploitation to me.
Exploitation? Or kill me. Johnny's mine. He's my kid. How can I exploit something I own? Sound like a cop. Kids in Russia, they don't work. That's why everything's so messed up over there. Get the wait line for toilet paper. And their train station was made out of milk cream. I'll tell you, working for a living is the American way. That, and the only thing more American is having folks work for you.
That sounds a little oppressive, even despotic.
Exactly right. You hit the nail on the head that time. My kid. Tell him you shut the school down, make the kids work. That book stuff all for sissies anyway.
And doctors, politicians, lawyers, whatever. I, you know, I can't be bothered to argue with you, but I do feel sorry for your little Johnny, the 7-year-old cook, chimney sweep, paralegal photocopier, because his daddy's an idiot. Let's take a quick break.
Phil and I just had another kid, so of course we need a bigger SUV. Being a mom's hard with soccer, football, and lacrosse practice, so we bought the new Ibatsu monstrosity. It's so big. We lost little Joey in the back and couldn't find him for an hour. When I'm rushing to the mall or talking on my cell phone, I know me and my family are safe. The Ibatsu monstrosity has four-wheel drive, and in amphibious mode, it can cross rivers. So far, I've only hit a few puddles, but it's good to know it's there. With the time I save taking shortcuts through the strip mall parking... Ibatsu monstrosity. Mine is bigger.
Would you like a giraffe? Have one delivered. Just log on to PetsOvernight.com and we'll send you a giraffe overnight. PetsOvernight.com, delivering little bundles of love in a box directly to your door.
All right, you are listening to Chatterbox, hosted by me, Laszlo, because I got kicked off the rock station. Let's go over here and talk to somebody about their life. Hello, caller, you're on the air.
Hi, Leslie. My name's Martha. I just love your show. I always listen to you when I'm getting my colon irrigated. I just wanted to say something about you.
I'm over. Can I do some business?
The highway and the World Wide Web?
Yeah, I know all about it.
Isn't it amazing? I mean, it's incredible. I know a lot of people say it's absolutely a load of crap, but how can it be so dumb? It's remarkable, I think. Think of all the things you can do. I mean, who do you want to buy an ATV? What do you do, Leslie?
I go to a shop, and the name's Laszlo.
I know, Leslie. I'm a regular listener. Well, I don't. I buy things online, and then I rip the music into digital format so I can listen to it while I'm jogging. It's incredible. I also like chess and cooking and reality. The internet is really good for my hobbies. I think it's amazing. I used to go out a lot, but I don't have to go out ever again. It's incredible. I don't envy those kids with their startups and with their fast cars. They earn them. The internet has saved my life.
This is really going nowhere. Do you have anything interesting to say at all?
Well, I want to see the Declaration of Independence.
That's phenomenal. Probably one of the reasons there are so many single men.
Beautiful. Just beautiful. All right, just the guy I need to talk to. All right, there's a car stuffed with a stiff at the cafe near Callahan Point. One of the Ferrellis thought he was a wise guy, so he got what he had coming to him. Take the corpse to the crusher in Harwood, all right?
Well, folks, if you're listening and want to make a difference, get yourselves down to the...
Later on in the show, if you're into health foods or martial arts, we'll have a special guest just for you. This guy's really special, kind of like a romantic cruise, but you can't walk on water. All right, let's go to the phones. Hello, caller, you're on Chatterbox.
Huh?
You're on Chatterbox. What's on your mind?
Oh, wow. I can't believe it.
Do you have a question?
Dude, I call every day and I never get through. Amazing. You do a great show, man.
Thanks. What's up?
Oh man, I'm serious. Really great. You're like a total inspiration.
And exactly what have I inspired you about?
Well, okay, right now I live at home, but pretty soon, like next week, dude, I'm moving out. It's the big 4-0, and it's just time to go.
Okay, did you have anything relevant to say?
Yeah, dude, that B dude was bogus. Really bogus. That's all. Great show, Laszlo.
I appreciate that. Tucker, it's going to be a great interview. We'll be right back.
A good shoe starts from the ground up. At Aris, we make high-quality footwear. In fact...
You can't try!
Tony's off making people bleed. Or trying to. He'll never be as tough as his pop. But he left you a note on the table.
The laundry has agreed to pay. You did real good, kid. Go collect the cash and bring it back here. Watch out for the triads. They may be shoving a firecracker up your ass. But don't take no crap. Nobody, I mean nobody, messes with Tony Cipriani.
Delivered overnight. PetsOvernight.com, delivering little bundles of love in a box directly to your door.
All right, now joining us in the studio, we have a very special guest. His new book, Karate and Digestion, has been on the top 100 self-help books for the past 3 weeks. He is the founder of Now and Zen Dojo and Organic Food Market in Trenton. His name is Reed Tucker. Welcome to Chatterbox, Reed.
Why, thank you, Laszlo. It certainly is an honor to be here today.
So tell me, Reed, where did you think of the idea of combining martial arts and organic food? I mean, it's kind of like putting ice cream on pizza. Both are great. Ninja period. You know, I had the Chinese stars and the nunchucks.
This is not a period, Laszlo. This is a way of life. Thanks to a strict vegan diet, I had the power of 9 men after morning meditation and a...
bleed. Or trying to. He'll never be as tough as his pop. But he left you a note on the table.
The laundry has agreed to pay.
Thank you.
the dairy on the top shelf of the fridge, so I couldn't reach it with my legs that we have my head now. But I grew weak and start knocking things down with the broom. What can I do, Reed?
Do not fret me, child.
Shut up, you carnivore. Why don't you go gnaw on a bone like a gorilla, Laszlo? Our ancestors didn't eat chicken wings. They lived at one with nature and their ecosystem, subsisting on a diet of nuts, berries, and leafy vegetables.
Yes, and they threw stones at their own shadow.
Don Salvatore has called a meeting. I need you to collect the limo and his boy Joey from the garage. Then get Luigi from his club. Come back here and pick me up. Then we'll all drive over to the boss's place together. Those triads, they don't know when to stop. They want a war, they got a war. Now get going.
In his own words, Reed Tucker is about to smash it into two half desks. Take it away, Reed.
Ladies and gentlemen, I already visualized the desk in two half desks, and now I shall make it so. Dragon Stance.
Hey-ya! Oh! Oh, Laszlo! Laszlo, I think I hurt my hand and my pinky's all bent the wrong way.
Listen, Karate Kid, the desk can steal it one piece. Thanks for coming on the show.
Okay, Laszlo, mockery will get you nowhere. I think I'm gonna hit you now.
Oh, I bruise easily. Don't throw any tofu or bean curds at me.
Okay, very funny, Laszlo. It's easy to make fun of me, but it's all the fault of the feng shui in here. Downright disgraceful.
Yes, it makes me talk like this. Okay, the listener lines are open. This is Chatterbox. You're on the air.
Hey, Laszlo. That last guy was a lunatic. Where'd you dig him up from? The state movie bin? And that wacko you had going on about killer bees? What a moron. I mean, just read a newspaper. Killer bees, the evils of artificial sweeteners and soda pop. Awesome.
MSXFM@movieshadow.com.
no fancy crap.
Did good back there, kid. Real good. Come on, let's introduce you to the Don.
Hey, Luigi!
Oh, my girls have been missing you so long, Salvatore. You've been away too long.
You tell them once this unfortunate business is taken care of, we'll all go down to the club and celebrate, okay? There's my boy.
How you doing, Pop?
You got yourself a good woman yet? Hey, your mother, God bless her soul, would be turning over in her grave to see you without a wife.
I know, Pop. I'm working on it.
Tony! How's your mama? She's a great woman, you know. Strong. Firenze.
She's good. Fine.
Terrific, terrific. Now listen, you guys, you go inside while I talk to our new friend here. I see nothing but good things for you, my boy. Me and the fellas need to talk business, so you're going to look after my girl for the evening. Hey, Maria, move your butt. Dumbra does this every time. And here she is, the one and only Queen of Sheba. What were you doing up there? Whatever it was, I bet it cost me money.
Well, you don't think I hang around here for the conversation, do you?
Get in the car and keep your big mouth shut. Take the limo, but bring it back in one piece, you hear me? And watch her. She can be trouble.
Yeah. I'm sure your new lapdog has everything covered. And isn't he big and strong? Hey, Fido, let's go visit Chico and get some party treats. He's at the rail station at the Chinatown waterfront, I think.
Smart with the little funny accent. I mean, I got something for him. Speak English, you limey moron.
Well, you know, I think they were speaking English before we were. The people over here were speaking Shoshone and Cherokee.
Man, Cherokee Schmerokee, man. And another thing, what's up with them calling soccer football? Man, you ever watch soccer? Man, that's a boring game, man. Yeah, I'll tell you what soccer is. Soccer's for little girls, man. Football, now that's an American sport. It teaches you good, wholesome American values, man, like stealing other people's land by force and wearing tight pants while you do it.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about being a man, Laszlo. Something you wouldn't know anything about from the sound of things. I'll tell you, I bet you played wimpy stuff like touch football and
I'm Mira, it's my favorite lady. You're looking for some fun? A little... some spank?
Hey, Chico. Nah, just the usual.
There you go, lady. Hey, maybe you should check out the warehouse party at the east end of Atlanta Keys.
Thanks, Chico. See you around.
Gracias. And enjoy. That's good stuff.
Got you, master. I got fly skills.
Come on, Fido. Let's go and check out this party.
I've got to see your point, but, you know, you'd be a little cranky, too, if your empire had fallen apart over the last 100 years. And speaking of commerce, it's time for some commerce here. Let's go to commercials. We'll be back after this.
Has your marriage gone stale? Has the spark gone out of your love life? Looking to add a little adventure to the monotony of monogamy? Hello, I am Fernando Martinez, founder of Fernando's New Beginnings, a revolutionary new way of saving your marriage. We understand how 2 kids and a mortgage can take the passion out of your life. With our 3-step program, you'll rediscover romance guaranteed.
Hi, my name's Phil.
I've got 3 kids, 2 cars, and a mortgage. My love life was going stale, even before my wife's car accident.
All right, buddy, you wait here and look after the car while I go to shoot my butt, right?
I meet Barbara at the motel by the turnpike.
See? The passion she's back. Phil's marriage is saved, and his kids will have a daddy to look up to. Call New Beginnings today. 555-9292. It will be a miracle. I guarantee it. Fernando's New Beginnings. We turn an ending into a new beginning.
4-5 to all units. This is narcotics raid at Manic Street.
What's this? How sweet. Gee willikers, it's a puppy.
It's alive.
And now you can ship one anywhere just by logging on to PetsOvernight.com. PetsOvernight.com, delivering little bundles of love in a box directly to your door.
And who says that e-commerce isn't the...
Here, Spider, come on, let's get out of here!
Me, Laszlo. Let's go over here to the phones and see what's plaguing Liberty City. Oh, caller, you're on the air.
Wow, I got through.
You know, I enjoyed myself for the first time in a long while, and you know, you treated me really good with respect and everything. I better go. I'll see you around.
Leave us alone for a minute. The Colombian cartel is making spank somewhere in Liberty, but we don't know where. And they seem to know everything we're doing before we do. We got us a rat. There's a guy named Curly Bob, works the bar at Luigi's. He's been throwing more money around than he's earning. He ain't pimping or pushing, so he must be talking. He usually gets a taxi home after work, so follow him. And if he's ratting us out, kill him.
Yeah, so I can come back here and have a bunch of hippies deny history. Those Aussies are ruthless. They've wired kangaroos with explosives. Come hopping into camp. Knock out 10 guys.
Well, thanks for the history lesson. All right, let's go over here. Hello, caller. You're on Chatterbox.
Yeah? Is that Laszlo?
Yes, it is. Who's this?
My name ain't important. It's real unimportant, okay?
No, not really. I mean, this is a radio show. People usually tell us their name.
My name is real unimportant. And you want to keep being a wise guy, you'll find out just how unimportant. Like, unimportant I just... just got shot in the head unimportant? Do I make myself clear?
Yes. Why are you calling in today?
Because I need some advice, and I ain't doing any of that shrink shit.
If you swear again, we're gonna have to cut you off. This is a family show.
Sorry. I'm just a little unhappy. I'm a bit agitated. Real angry. It's my mom. She don't think I'm a real man. Can you imagine that? I mean, I do a man's job and all, but she treats me like a little boy. All I get is, your pa this and your pa that, and you ain't a real man, Tony, and it's driving me freaking nuts.
Well, Tony...
Tony? How'd you know my name was Tony? You're tracing this call? Because if you are, you're gonna get real intimately acquainted with what your brains look like. My name ain't Tony, okay?
Okay.
But my mom, she keeps going, Tony, Tony, be a real man. Stand up for yourself. Don't take no shit. But all I do is to be a good son. And I want her to show that she cares for me. Show that she loves me. And, you know... say I was a good kid, but it seems like nothing's ever good enough for her, you know what I mean? What do I do?
Well, Toad, I mean, sir, you know, in life we have a lot of obligations, and we just kind of have to face up to them. And right now, I'm obligated to...
For everyone. He's got fur and a tail. He gets in lots of trouble, but he's a bouncy little fellow, because he's got springs for...